triage is finding out how severe the patient actually is. That's just triage by itself. Where we do a mass amount of triage is at what we call an MCI event, a mass casualty incident. Now, all an MCI is, it means there's more patients, there's more resources required than a typical call. And we need help from other agencies, more resources, more help, more assistance, because the number of patients and resources needed is so high. It's a special event. It's an MCI event. Now, this is what an MCI kind of looks like. Just so you understand, like, where are we going to be doing like this mass amount of triage with so many patients? Well, at this type of events. Now, so this is the lay of the land. We have the incident. So the incident is like where the actual event has taken place. It could be an extremely large car accident. It could be a fire. It can be industrial, right? So many different things. The incident. Now, I'm going to take you on a patient journey quick. Let's say that we have a patient in here, right? We have to extricate the patient. Then we got to triage that patient. That's what this video is about, triage. Then we got to treat that patient. And then we got to transport that patient. But depending on our triage, we'll determine what happens over in treatment and transport. Let's get into it. Remember, triage is simply sorting patients based upon how severe their injuries are. We have primary and secondary triage. These are key terms you gotta know. Primary triage is when we tag the patient, when we first approach the patient, we do a quick little exam. I'm gonna show you it in this video. We're gonna tag the patient, and then later on when they make it to the treatment area, remember that little chart from earlier? And then make it a treatment area, we're gonna reassess and do a secondary triage. When we do our primary triage and we tag our patients, there are four main tags. So first is red. The red is immediate or critical. These patients do have a chance of survival, but they need immediate care and immediate transport. Yellow is delayed. They're gonna need care, they're gonna need transport, but they have more time on their hands. They may have hours versus minutes, right? So you think make minutes, hours, right? For an example, to paint a picture in your mind. Now green, green is the walking wounded. So the first thing that we do in start triage, I'm gonna show you here in a second how it all works. First thing to start triage is we get a megaphone or we're able to get an air horn and say, anyone that can walk, that can get away from the incident, do so and go here. Not toward the ambulance, but go here. So that way we have all of the green in one spot. So now we know the black, yellow, and red, they're all still in the incident and we have to go figure out who's red, who's yellow, and then which one we're gonna tag black, right? Now finally, the black tag is DOA or dead on arrival, meaning the patient may not be 100% deceased just yet, but with the injuries that we've seen and the little tests that we're gonna do, and I'll show it to you here in a second, it's very, very unlikely they're gonna survive, so they're tagged black. And now remember, with this triage system, there's a lot of chaos, there's a lot going on. The whole goal of this tag system is to do the most good for the most amount of people in this chaotic situation. And that's why we have these four tags. Step one of our start triage is to call out to the walking wounded. So we're gonna call out, we're gonna use our megaphone, we're gonna move the patients over that are able to walk. So we're gonna call out, if you're able to walk, move to this object or move to this area. And now we have our green settled. Now we just gotta figure out, well, who's gonna be a black tag? Who's gonna be a yellow tag? Who's gonna be a red tag? And that's where we move on to step two. So here we go, I'm approaching my patient that's unable to walk. The first thing I'm gonna do is assess the respiratory status or respirations. So I approach the patient, is the patient breathing? If they're breathing, hang on, we're gonna get that in a second. What if the patient's not breathing? Well, we're gonna open the airway. So I open the patient's airway. Is the patient breathing? If they're not breathing, as you're opening the airway, you're trying to move the airway, it's not working, they're not breathing. Black tag. If, once you open the airway, they start to spontaneously breathe, red tag. Now, let's back up to right here, which is, what's the respiratory rate if they are breathing? So if they are breathing, what's the respiratory rate? If it's between 10 and 30, we are going to move on. If it's under 10, breathing too slow, or it's above 30, breathing way too fast, we're gonna tag them red. Okay, so now step three. I'm gonna get the patient's radio pulse, right? So we're gonna get that radio pulse in the patients, and what do we get back? Do they have a radio pulse? Move on. If they don't have a radio pulse, that means the patient most likely is gonna be severely hypotensive. Mark the patient red. Now, moving on to step four is gonna be mental status. So I would tell the patient, can you show me two fingers? Can you show me three fingers? Can you grip my hands? These are all simple commands that people can do in chaotic situations, right? So if they're able to do that, and let's say I say, squeeze my hands, they do that, we're gonna tag yellow. If they're not able to do that, or the patient is unconscious or unresponsive, then we're going to tag red. If you are getting ready for school, in school right now, or preparing to pass your national registry exams, the first link in the description is what I give to all my students, over 420 plus videos of content, quizzes, and access to our private student community group to ask me questions throughout your journey. It's the first link in the description down below. And just for watching this video, I'm gonna give you a lifetime access to my video vault. And on the screen right now, you're gonna see a video. It's gonna help you tremendously with your education. Go watch it.